We want our past governors to be working. A lot of them didn't do that during their year as governor. District governor.
Okay.
In some multiple districts, it's common for the past district governor to be pushed to the background, and in one multiple district that I have visited, they have what they call a boneyard. And when you become a past district governor, you go to the boneyard. We don't allow that to happen in the state of Texas. We want our past governors to be working. A lot of them didn't do that during their year as governor. They worked hard enough this past year that Texas, for the third year in a row, had a plus in revenue. And that is fantastic, and we're proud of them for that. Now, there are a lot of things I could say about this group, but I will not, because I have to live here in the state of Texas. But if you would, ladies and gentlemen, if you turn this way, I want to have you take your oath of office and become a member of this august body of past district governors as soon as you pay your dues. And my advice to each of you would be to pay your dues for a life membership. Some of you may not live long, but so that's the best way to do that. Nobody thought I'd live the 3 years to make up for that anyway. But if you would, repeat after me. This oath of office. When I was district governor, I believe all of them did that okay. You'll hear that many times from this group. I hereby declare you, some of them it took two shots to get it right, past district governor of the great state of Texas, Baltimore District 2, as soon as you pay your dues. Because at this time, the Texas Lions Foundation is going to present to those of you who have earned them, and all of you did this year. We're delighted with the fact that every governor and every trustee in the Texas Lions Foundation this year earned the Ed Flood Award. So, anyway.